Hi, I'm Angela Fuller, and I'm with the Monroe, Louisiana store. I'm a Master 2 designer with Ulta Beauty, and today I'm going to be doing a demo on hair cutting techniques and color. And this is my model, Christy. Today we are going to be adding a lot of texture with her hair. We're going to take off a little bit of length. I'm going to incorporate using the shears, the razor, and the clippers on her hair. Now with her color, we're basically, Christy really does a whole lot with her color. She likes to swap it up. So we are going to be using the Redken Shades EQ gloss on her hair. I'm going to try to tone out some of this blonde. I'm gonna tone out some of the brassiness in there. There's not a lot, but there's still a little bit. She really likes the ashy blonde. And we're gonna pull through some violet tones through the tips of her hair. So that's what we're gonna be doing with Christy today. So let's get started. Okay, so I have Christy's hair color mixed up, and what I've mixed is the Redken Shades EQ Gloss. I've mixed a 1/2 ounce of the 9P and 1/2 ounce of the 9T. So that's really gonna give her a cool blonde. So when you're using the Shades EQ Gloss, it tends to be a little bit runny, which is usually what we want, but in this case, because I am applying it as like a color retouch, I need it to be a little bit thicker. So if you see, I've added the Redken color thickener to the gloss, which is gonna thicken it up some, so it won't run through her hair as I'm applying it. And the next color that I've mixed up is the violet. And what I have in here is also the Shades EQ Gloss. It's a 7V with a violet kicker. So what I mixed was 1 ounce of the 7V and 1/4 ounce of the violet kicker with 1 1/4 ounce of the processing solution. So this is gonna be the violet that we pull through the tips of her, the top section of her hair. Okay, so now I'm fixing to apply the first formula that I've mixed, and I'm gonna apply this to zone 1. I'm gonna do this all over, and then we're gonna go back in with the violet with some foils and put that through her tips. Okay, so I've applied the first solution onto zone 1. Now what I'm fixing to do is bring it into zone 2 and then pull the violet through her ends, through her tips. Take thin sections. I'm using a smaller brush like this just because it's easier for me with shorter hair. And also whenever I'm pulling this through her tips, I can feather it in a little bit easier than the bigger brushes. Then what I'm gonna do is just lay another foil, because I am gonna do all of her tips. I'm just gonna lay another foil right on top. That way it doesn't get as bulky. Take another thin section. Bring that solution down. Then we're gonna add the violet. I'm going to go until I finish the whole top section of her hair.
have light.
Okay, so I'm applying Satin Wear to her hair. We just finished shampooing and putting a conditioner on her hair. I'm just putting this through because it really gives it, it helps that razor to slide through the hair easily. It helps get a good clean cut. So I'm applying that before I even start her cut. All I'm gonna do is I'm gonna take this top section and I'm just gonna section it off. You can use clips if you'd like. Her hair is so short, you really don't have to use clips. You can just pretty much comb it to the front. You can see the purple or the violet through there. Okay. Now what I really want to do with her cut is take a lot of this out. I'm going to leave length hair, but I want to take some of this weight, some of this length off, and then heavily texture this. But I'm going to start in the back first. And I don't want a blunt cut on her. All right, so I'm gonna get her just to tilt her head just slightly. I'm gonna come right at her hairline. Tilt my fingers down so that the underneath's not flipping out. And I'm gonna point cut my guide. And I'm kind of angling around the curve of her head and her hairline. If you see I've missed a couple, that's okay. I'm just gonna lightly come through. It's supposed to look piecey, so it's okay. Doesn't have to be a harsh line. We're not going for that look today. What I'm gonna do is I'm gonna take this bottom as my guide. Short piece and slightly angle. I'm gonna pull it out and slightly angle. Get my point, angle. I'm holding it a little bit differently than what I normally would. Just so you can see what I'm doing. Now a hand angle, everything like that is normal, but sometimes I would cut a little bit differently. See how that, you don't see lines? Point cutting, I mean, can almost give the effect of a razor. When it comes to adding movement to the layers. Okay, we're keep an angle, almost like a sideburn for her, but we are gonna take it up just a little bit. Not necessarily up over the ear because the other side is, we're gonna be using the clippers, and so we do want to keep some hair over here just to keep that look that she has. So what I'm gonna do is take the perimeter of my piece from the back, and I'm going to angle up towards her ear. And again, I'm point cutting. How to come up to the tip of the ear, I'm going to angle my hand down. And around her ear, I'm actually gonna not angle it quite as much. I'm not gonna angle it as much, so I'm gonna pull out.
And I'm going to hit those points in here. The angle is really just going to kind of create a little bit of weight through here, but I don't want quite as much through this area. I see just a little bit of weight right in here. I'm gonna come up with it. We cut through here, so I'm just gonna come up just a little bit. And you see where the weight is? Right through here. And you see where the weight is? Right through here. So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna change shears. I like to use my thinning shears for this. I'm not gonna like thin her hair out. I like to point cut with these shears. It's starting to remove a little bit of the weight up here. I really like to move the hair because you can see once it falls if it's going to weigh down or not. So don't be afraid to get in there and really, really mess with it. Kind of move it both ways, back and forth. See, just a hair of weight just right here. So I'm taking my detachable blade clippers, which some of you may be familiar with. They are not the guard attachments. These are the heavy duty blades. They cut smoother, they cut faster. That's why I use them, because in a salon, when you're in a fast paced environment, time is money. So this really knocks down having to go over it and over it. I've got a 3.5 blade on here. So if you're using an attachment guard, you would put the 3 on it and open it halfway and come in and kind of scoop out. You see how clean cut that is? They sound like an airplane taking off, but that's okay. Really be careful around their ear. With a guard, you don't have to worry about that as much. With a blade, it's just like using a clipper without a guard. It can nick their ear. You don't want to get anywhere close. And I'm a licensed barber, and I taught at a barber school, so I really love clipper work. This is one of my passions, is incorporating clipper work into my haircut. So when I get to do that, it's really fun for me. Okay, so her length is cut down. We're not necessarily tapering it in. If we taper it in, she's almost gonna look bald because she's so light. So we're just gonna stop with that 3.5. Okay, so we just finished up with her style. We just applied rough paste to the dry hair and just kind of molded it how we want it. She really likes that Tussle Messy look. I'm just finishing off with Wind Blown. She doesn't like a heavy hairspray. That rough paste really holds that hair good. This is just going to take care of the sides and the back, just really to give a good finishing hold to the rest of the hair. So I'm just going to spray just a little bit of it. Okay. So this is her final style.